Hi there. I'm Kyle Burke with the customer success team here at MuleSoft, and in this Friends with Max video series, I'd like to discuss with you the MuleSoft Mule Migration Assistant, also known as MMA. This is MuleSoft's solution to help kickstart and accelerate your Mule 3 to Mule 4 journey. In today's video, I'd like to discuss with you what the Migration Assistant is, what the tool can do for you, and then also how you can gain access, and also help improve the tool. Without further ado, let's jump right in. The Mule Migration Assistant, which is often referred to as MMA, is MuleSoft's open source tool which is used to assist in the conversion process of Mule 3 applications to Mule 4 applications. The MMA tool is run from a command line, which will take a Mule 3 application as an input and output a Mule 4 application, along with a conversion report, which notes any of the errors that occurred during the conversion process. It's important to note that the intention of the MMA is to help kickstart and accelerate the conversion of Mule 3 applications to Mule 4 applications. But due to the complexity of some of the applications and the conversion process associated with them, it will not always be able to convert 100% of the applications. Being that the MMA tool won't translate 100% of your applications, this naturally brings up the question of what will the MMA tool translate for you? There are several Mule 3 components that will be able to directly be converted over to Mule 4 components. These include the individual flows and their overall logic, the global configurations that are governing your applications, the DataWeave 1 and Mule Expression Language scripts, which will be converted into DataWeave 2 scripts, your unit tests, which are written in MUnit, the policies you've applied to your applications, as well as a subset of connectors, transports, and modules. It's important to note that not all the connectors, modules, and transports are able to be automatically converted with the MMA. For a full list of what's supported by the Mule Migration Assistant, be sure to check out our documentation site at docs.mulesoft.com for more of our formal documentation. As was previously mentioned, the MMA is intended to kickstart the migration of Mule 3 applications, but will not always be able to convert every aspect of these applications. So what happens when your Mule 3 applications contain components that cannot be directly converted to Mule 4 components? For this, MuleSoft has provided a report that guides you on how you should approach the conversion process for these components that were not directly converted. This conversion report will highlight components of your applications that will need to be fully rewritten, components that need to be partially rewritten with similar Mule 4 components, or components of your applications that have been slightly modified to conform with Mule 4 standards, but with no major functionality changes. As was previously mentioned, the MMA will be an open source tool that will be hosted on MuleSoft's GitHub. Being that MMA is open source, it will not be part of MuleSoft's commercial endpoint platform offerings, and therefore will not be supported by the MuleSoft support team. But with that being said, this also means that the tool is completely free, available to download, modify, and redistribute as needed by any of our customers, partners, or anybody else. The reason MuleSoft decided to make this tool open source is it allows us to use the full power of our amazing customers and partners to help make this tool even better by allowing them to contribute their findings back into the tool to improve the tool base for others. The Mule Migration Assistant is publicly available to download from MuleSoft's GitHub repository. From here, any one of our customers, partners, or the community at large can download the tool and also contribute back to the project if they so choose to. Within the Git repository, you will find lots of documentation around the tool, how it's used, as well as the process for contributing back to the project. For anyone that's familiar with the Mule Community Edition, the rules of engagement are very similar. Essentially, if you wish to contribute, there will be a set of guidelines and preconditions that will need to be met before you can do a pull request on the project to contribute back. Thank you so much for watching this video today, where we discussed what the Mule Migration Assistant is, what it can do for you, and also how you can gain access and contribute to the tool. In the next Friends with Max video in this video series, we're going to be taking a deeper dive into the tool, understanding how the tool works, and then what the outputs look like, and then what are the steps you need to take after you do the conversion. Until then, I hope you have a great time with your Mule 3 to Mule 4 migration journey, and best of luck.